So, I just landed in Tokyo. The one place where getting off the metro, you can get lost in an underground mall. The flight from DC to here goes over Alaska and it flies over the Barents Sea, which is just south of the Arctic Circle. And I was like going to the bathroom or something, and I peeked out the window and I saw this vast, amazing sight of a frozen ocean that was basically kind of breaking up and melting. It made me so curious about ice. Hello. By every measure, what I was looking at out that window is a record. It's a record low of ice pack for the Arctic Ocean. We're talking like over the past like several thousand years. Okay, fine, I'll go to Uniqlo. This Uniqlo has 11 stories. 12 stories. So it turns out that ice is actually way more important than you think. At least it was way more important than I thought. One of the more interesting functions that ice plays is that it acts as a giant reflector, basically bouncing a bunch of sunlight back up into space so that the Earth doesn't have to absorb it. And this is actually super vital for keeping the Earth's systems regulated. The ice also keeps ocean currents running smoothly, which a lot of species depend on, including humans. Ice is more than just important for polar bears. It actually has huge ramifications for like our entire global ecosystem and all of the many systems that support it. I came to Tokyo for a totally different story. It has nothing to do with climate change. I'm pretty sure jaywalking in Japan is like a total faux pas. Hello. Definitely, everyone's laughing at me right now. The view I had while flying over Alaska was beautiful, but the story it tells is one of potential disaster for our globe. I'm actually in Japan working on a couple of really interesting videos. I won't give any spoilers away, but give you a hint. It has to do with North Korea and with racist people.